First ever event here at the Modoc Raceway. And here we go. Qualifying is now underway out of Chickamauga, Georgia, in the Bad Boy. Off-road sponsor 17M. Warrior Chassis ECR engine up under the hood. It will be the Mac Daddy, Dale McDowell. And behind him in the Penske Shots, Cushman Paint and Body sponsor Longhorn. 101 machine out of Toccoa, Georgia. It's gonna be Casey Roberts. For Dale McDowell on lap one. 17.677 for Casey Roberts on his second go round. All righty, so far, Casey Roberts the fastest with a 17.185 on his fastest go around, and McDowell was 17.664 for his fastest of the two cars. Next machine out of Evans, Georgia, the 2015 Craftsman Late Model Series Rookie of the Year. It's gotta be Brandon Overton. Big Sexy is in the house. And behind him in the 77 out of Augusta, Georgia, is gonna be Brian Connor. And Overton clocks in with a 17.632 on his first go around. And Brandon Overton, a 17.349 second quick. He picks it up on a second go around to a 17.248 on his second go around. The Dirt Late Model Simulator with saying over here on the side of the grandstands. All right, qualifying is back up underway. The next car coming out. And the number 42 machine is gonna be Doug Sanders. Out of Springwood, North Carolina. And coming up behind him out of Blue Ridge, Georgia, is going to be former Southern All-Star Series champion Shane Tankersley. Doug Sanders clocking in with an 18.057 on his first go around. Shane Tankersley clocking in with a 19.147 on his first go around. Doug Sanders picking it up on lap two to a 17.832 on this big 4/10 mile speed plan and out of four. Tankersley hard on the throttle. Clocks in a little bit faster to a 18.763 on his second go around. Next machine out in the number 12 in the Capital race car, Vincent Race Engines under the hood. In the Wins Manufacturing, number 12 out of Gray, Georgia, is Hunter Peacock. He picked up the big 10,000 to win at the Gobbler 100 at Cocker Motor Speedway last weekend. And behind him in the number 11, it's gonna be out of Piedmont, Alabama, it's gonna be Ryan Law.
That's Terry Bullard.
My bad. Terry Bullard there coming out there in the number 11, sorry there. That's why I got good guys like Kelly here to help me on some of that stuff. Terry Bullard unclocked in with a 19.993. And Peacock on the second go around, 18.059 for his second go around. Terry Bullard, see if he can pick it up. He does to a 19.345 for Terry Bullard here on the big 4/10 mile.
They ain't bothering you.
No. I was gonna do that.
Next machine out. And the Black 11 is gonna be out of Piedmont, Alabama. It's gonna be the Lawman, Ryan Law. And it's Big A Anthony Sanders in the building, cranking it up, and he's gonna clock in with a 17.214 this go around. Ryan Law with an 18.848 for his go. Sixth Sanders picking it up on lap two to a 17.117 at second go around. 19.154 for Ryan Law. But going to the top of the board is Big A, Anthony Sanders. So Anthony Sanders has now topped the board over Casey Roberts. Crate Lake. Popping out next onto the Speedway out of Elberton, Georgia, is going to be the Hammer, Brent Dixon. And coming up behind him out of Douglasville, Georgia, is going to be racing Mason Massey. And Brent Dixon's going to bring it to the line. 17.647 as he goes up in two. Mason Massey, 18.715, his first go around. Coming out of turn number four, Brent Dixon hard on the throttle. 17.396 for Mr. Brent Dixon. He goes to fifth quick overall, and Mason Massey comes in. 18.360 for the young man out of Douglasville, Georgia, going to ninth quick. He goes into the fifth place, and next machine out. This track starting to get to his liking. Got a very heavy right foot. It's going to be Brian Ligon and the number four out of Augusta, Georgia. And coming up behind him, and the 44 out of Gray Cork, South Carolina, and the Cushman Paint Body Hemrick sponsored. Number 44, Longhorn Chassis, is going to be Chris Smokey Madden. Brian Ligon to a 17.522 for the young man out of Augusta. New quick, second quick time for Chris Mann, a 17.274. That's fourth quick for Chris Mann. Sorry on that. Brian Ligon goes to a 17.401 on his second go round. Chris Mann, a 17.050. New quick time for Chris Smokey Mann. So Chris Smokey Madden is now top of the board with a 17.050. We're going to see what the man out of Gray Court, if he can hold on with a couple of guys left in qualifying. Next machine out in the 24D machine, one of the local heroes here at the Modoc Speedway. It'll be Michael Brown. Behind him, out of Virginia, the long haul. It will be Mr. Walker Arthur. Michael Brown, a 18.233 on that first go around, and a 17.854 for Walker Arthur on his first go around. Michael Brown trying to get some grip out of turn four. He will cross the stripe. 17.613, that's second go around. And Walker Arthur picking up to a 17.551 on his second go around. Crate Late Model, you're next. We need you. So Kyle Pierce, the final qualifier in the Super Late Models. He gets to the loud pedal for his first of two green flag qualifying laps. Out of turn four, Kyle Pierce, he will see the white flag for his lap one. 18.379 for Kyle Pierce on his first go around. He must get up on the game if he wants to knock Chris Mann off the pole. And the turns three and four. Can Kyle Pierce make it work? He's got a good line coming to the line. He picks it up quite a bit to a 17.876, but not enough to knock Chris Mann off the pole. So out of Gray Court, South Carolina.